Great to see you. How you feeling tonight?
I feel great.
You look good. Are you ready and pumped up here for the fight against Lucy?
Of course, always. Yeah.
One of the things that we saw, especially in the weigh-ins, because you couldn't tell in pictures, but she's quite tall.
Yeah.
Have you changed anything up preparing for this, or is it business as usual? Where, and let's be honest, I talked to Scott before we went on the air. I'm looking forward to you two the most. I think it's got fight of the night potential written all over it. Both of you go, pardon my friend, but you go balls to the wall. No, don't hold back. I mean, how excited are you for this fight?
I'm stoked. It's a fight that's been in the making for a while, and there's been some talk going back and forth between her camp and my camp, and it finally got sorted out, and now today we're here and we're ready to do it, and I'm thrilled.
So was there anything personal going on? I mean, I know there was some, a little bitterness back and forth, and the last time you were fighting here, you talked about and you mentioned your desire to fight her. Is it all kind of just fabricated, or was there really some desire there?
Yeah, I'm not mad at anybody I fight. There were some words exchanged, and they weren't, derogatory or anything. It was just kind of like, oh, you're ducking me. And I'm like, no, I'm not. I called you out. How was that ducking you?
After Alexis, you did.
Yeah, because, I heard that that's when it all started, that, they started this rumor that I was ducking her because of her height. And it just so happened that Alexis had got that fight before she did, so automatically I was ducking her. So after that fight, I was like, hey, Lucy, let's fight. I'm not ducking you, so there's no hard feelings, not on my end anyway. I'm just thrilled to be able to do what I love here, and it's for the title, so that just makes it even better.
When you said that the rumors were that you were ducking her, it was because of her height. What are your thoughts on her height? How do you deal with that? How do you deal with her height? How do you plan to solve that riddle? And what she said when we spoke to her actually was it wasn't that her height that's her greatest advantage, it's her length. So what's your strategy? You could tell us, we won't tell anyone.
I just use my angles, and just do what I do best, and I move. I guess if I'm known for something, one of the things that, one of my advantages that I play really well is I use my movement, and I know how to use it against shorter opponents, same size opponents, taller opponents, bigger, faster, whatever. My movement is what I'm good at, and it keeps working, so I'm going to keep using it.
They say speed kills, and you do. You got the speed and the footwork, so it works to your advantage very well.
Thank you, yeah.
Well, Tiffany, I assume you must be getting, a bit hyped up, or I guess if you're either in a zone or really hyped up, because you've been on a media tour since this morning. You've been talking to a number of different outlets here in Las Vegas about tonight's fight versus England's Lucy Payne. And again, doors are open here at the joint inside the Hard Rock Hotel and Casino. Some of the fights are going to start in about 20 minutes, but, now that all the talking is over, now that the time has come for the fight, what should fans that maybe have never seen a Muay Thai fight, especially a female Muay Thai fight, expect out of what you and Lucy are going to bring into the ring this evening?
It's definitely going to be some fireworks. Absolutely. I know Lucy fights hard every time. Every time she steps in the ring, I know I fight hard every time I step into the ring. And it's just going to be a test of will and a test of skill. And whoever has more of one or both is going to come out with their hand raised, and it's going to be me.
Yeah, that's great. I love the swagger and the confidence. I'm going to ask all of our hosts here, Joey, Phil, Heidi, because we had Lucy on, obviously, earlier in the show from England. Lucy works two jobs. I know that you have a job when we spoke to you on the air as well, but you train in an MMA gym, correct?
UFC
gym down there in Southern California. So part of your career keeps you involved in the fight game all the time, where she works as a beautician across the seas there. How much do you think that has to do, as far as advantage go to Tiffany? Because you're here in the States, obviously, training's a little bit differently, and the fact that your job gets you involved in more training, do you think that's going to be a bit of an advantage?
No, it's just part of my lifestyle. I've grown up in a karate dojo, in a gym, or on a soccer field, so I've always been active. I think my career choice I blame it on my ADD. Because I've tried to work a desk job, I've tried to work retail, and I just can't do it. I've got to be on my feet, I've got to be moving.
If that's ADD, then I think you could count us all in for something like that here, because I don't know anybody that could do a bunch of that. We've got about 5 minutes here, guys, until we're going to be jumping off of our second hour of the live stream before we do go live to Sports 920 The Game. And again, we're talking to Tiffany Van Soest here, who is going to be fighting England's Lucy Payne, one of the main fights here in tonight's Lion Fight 10. So, Tiffany, we're on Access TV. Obviously, when we talked to Lucy, they don't have Access TV over in England as a network. You can watch it online. How excited are your friends, families, neighbors, relatives for tonight's fight on Access?
they tell me they're excited because a lot of the time, my friends, family, students, whoever, I fight in Vegas a lot because I'm signed to Lion, and that's where the show is. They can't make it out to Vegas, and like, oh, can I watch your fight? And now I can say, yes, you can. It's on TV, so it's awesome that, you know, everybody. I have a big, big support team, big following, and so it's really cool that all those people are able to watch what I do. They see me in the gym. They see me, you know, working my butt off, and so it's cool that they can actually still see that all come into play and under the lights on when it counts.
It's got to be super exciting too, though. Not just to say that, like, yeah, you can watch my fight on TV, but just to say I fight on TV.
Absolutely.
Like, some people fight, you know. Oh yeah, I'm a professional fighter. No, it's in a ballroom in Timbuctu, you know. And,
that's how
you know,
usually. That's how it used to be.
Yeah, right.
Wild
but now you're like,
Bills, Tuesday night.
You're a fighter. Are you really? Yeah, I fight on TV.
You know, you had fought Jerry Seitz before. I think that was Lion Fight 7 for the WBC title.
Yeah.
Now, does this one have a different feeling to it, being that it's a Lion Fight title?
It's special because it's the first one. That's for sure. Yeah. I can say that I'm the first.
Absolutely.
And I'm thrilled to be a part of that. And so, I mean, I'm a big thank you to Scott Kent and Christine. So.
Well, what's cool about Lion Fight is they are the first, you know, North American Muay Thai, you know, promotion that's gotten onto Access TV or gets to be on live TV. What's the exposure been like for you? Have a lot more people, do you get noticed more often in the street?
No, I can still go grocery shopping without being noticed, which is cool because I like to keep to myself. I'm pretty mellow. I know, like, when I get on here, I just get excited, but, like, outside of everything, I'm actually very mellow, very private. But I just have more followers on Twitter and Facebook.
You know that's going to change, right? You're not going to be able to go to the store in like a year or two. You know that, right?
We'll see.
Yeah. I love on Twitter when you're talking about chilling out that you're usually quoting some kind of reggae tune when you do it.
That's me. I'm go, go, go all the time. So when I'm not in the gym, I'm chilling out.
Yeah. Well,
you know, when we talked to you last week on the MMA Fight Corner, you know, Joey was asking, you know, so besides all the great relaxing stuff that you do, what do to unwind? Because you get to surf. I mean, you get to hang out in SoCal. You work at a UFC gym. So it sounds like you get to incorporate a bit of Zen into your life on a daily basis.
I always try to, whatever
it is that you're doing, you're bringing a bit of that Zen and that peace in there. So, again, we're super excited for the fight. It's coming up here, guys, in just a couple of hours. I'm sure you have got tons of stuff to do pre-fight in preparation.
Tons of relaxing.
Go listen to some great Bob Marley or something like that.
Yeah.
You know, every little thing is going to be all right.
Absolutely.
I don't have the great accent for it, but you know, I know that's true. Well, again, Tiffany Van Soest fighting England's Lucy Payne in tonight's Lion Fight 10. Doors are open down here at the joint inside the Hard Rock Hotel and Casino. Fights are going to start, guys, in about 20, 25 minutes. And then, of course, the main card at 7 p.m. starts getting underway. So, again, Tiffany, thank you so much for coming on.
Thank you, guys.
Best
for having
of luck.
Me.
And
thank
I hope
you.
We get to talk to you again on the Fight
Definitely
Corner.
Definitely will.
Our
awesome.
Pleasure.
All right. Bye, guys.